Let's go ahead and create a basic class. So again, the way that we define a class is by using the keyword class here and then give it a name. So I'm going to say presenter, just like that. Now, I can go ahead and start defining all of the functions and whatever else it is that I might want. Most commonly, you're going to start with a constructor here. So I'm going to go ahead and just simply say def, and then underscore, underscore, and then init. And now you'll notice that Visual Studio is automatically going to help me out here, that I just hit tab and then it just gave me this autocomplete, which can be helpful sometimes. For right now though, I'm not overly worried about what's going on there. So I'm just going to do a little bit of cleanup and I'm going to add in that name parameter there. So now I'm going to say self.name equals name. And I'm going to add in my little say hello. So def say hello self, and then we'll go ahead and say print, and then self.name. Cool. So now I'm ready to actually use this presenter class. And the way that I'm going to use this is by saying presenter equals presenter, pass in a name. I'm going to say Chris. Of course, if you know me at all, you know that my name is, in fact, Christopher. So let's go ahead and fix that mistake, just like that. And now let's go ahead and run presenter and say hello. Boom, boom. Cool. So now that I've got all of that, let me go ahead and run this little sample. So let me change directories. Where are all my directories? 0, 3. There I am. There we go. Just do a little bit of cleanup there. Okay, now I'm in the right directory. So now let's go ahead and say Python and then my basic class.py. And what you're going to notice is that it prints out Christopher. And again, the reason that it prints out Christopher is because my say hello is going to print out that name. And of course, I went ahead and set that right there. If I didn't have that line of code, we'll just go ahead and comment that out. We'll rerun everything. And now you're going to notice that it will just print out Chris. So just kind of proof the fact that it is grabbing that from the constructor and setting that inside of the object. Now let's turn our attention to a property. So I've already got all the code written out, so that way you don't have to watch me type everything. But I am going to do a couple of little additions in here. The first thing that I want you to notice is in my constructor that I'm going to go ahead and leave the exact same code as self.name. But we're actually right here calling the property. So we are not going in and accessing the field behind the scenes, but rather we're calling the property. Very specifically, here, and I'll put this in red just to sort of drive the point home here. I am not saying self.underscore_name equals name. I'm not doing that. And the reason that I'm not doing that is because as a best practice, if you create a property, you should always use the property. The property is there for a reason. That the property is going to be executing some level of validation, or maybe it's going to be updating something somewhere else, or it's doing something. You're creating it for a reason. And if you're creating it for a reason, you should always call that property. That one little bug that can very easily creep into your code is calling the property in some places and not calling it in other places. Don't do that. You're just going to ask for heartache there. If you set up the property, always call the property. Even though, yeah, I know I'm inside the class, I could just go ahead and call that underscore underscore name. Don't do it. You're just asking for heartache. Okay. So now I've got my property set up. Whoops. Stop it. I've got my property set up here. It's just highlighting that fact inside of Visual Studio. That's fine. So I've got my property set up, and now I want to go ahead and define the getter side. So again, this is going to return my value. You'll notice that this is going to return my name. I'm going to add in just a little bit of code here. I'm just going to say print and then in the getter, just to highlight the fact that, hey, we're inside of there. So this will return back that name. And then here's the setter. You'll notice that what we're doing here is we're setting up a brand new little attribute right here, name, and you'll notice, of course, that matches up there. So that's how those two are being tied together. We're identifying the fact that this is going to be a setter. And so now what I can do is set up whatever cool validation it is that I might want. In my case, I'm just going to say print in setter, just like that, and prove the fact that we're inside of there. Now, once I get down to my code, you'll notice I'm going to create an instance of the presenter just like before. One more time, I'm going to go ahead and update the name. And then finally, I'm going to go ahead and print out the name. So if I run this, what you're going to notice is the fact that we are in the setter, in the getter, and then it's printing out my name. Now, you might notice up here that it's running the in the setter twice. So we've accessed the setter side of our property twice. And you might be going, well, wait a minute. I only see that happening once. I only see that happening here. Well, remember, we called the constructor. And if you remember, we had a big, long talk about this. Up here in my constructor, I've called the setter there. Because again, best practice, if you create a property, you should always use the property. So that's how we can set up a class inside of Python, and that's also how we can take advantage of properties to get a little bit more control over how it is that somebody is going to use our class.